Okay, so after I am ready with the historical data, after I am ready with the MetaTrader, I actually funded a live account yesterday, which I'll be using for the purpose of this course to show you some live trading with the EAs. Now I am ready to show you how to use the software in more details. And I will try to cover everything you need to know to get started. And because I know many people start using FSB Pro because they can build strategies from scratch and automate them into robots, I will open a new strategy and I will show you a manual strategy that I have personally automated and works really well for me until the time I'm recording this videos. And to be honest with you, I found FSB Pro because I was hiring developers and it was really hard. So I looked for a program where I can automate strategies without programming needed. Okay, so if you have a manual strategy, you can build it in here and see the results. And this will save you tons of time on testing strategies manually on a demo or live accounts. So many people lose their money because they don't backtest the strategy. So that's a mistake you wanna avoid. Okay, now let me show you how to build a strategy from scratch. And the first thing I will do is to change the opening condition. So on the top, we have the opening logic conditions and below we have the closing logic conditions. Okay, I will put a few that will predefine where my trade will open. And then I will put a closing condition, which will close the trades automatically. As well, we have the strategy properties, or this is the entry amount we use, the maximum position amount, and some additional entry signal settings that I will explain right now. Now, let's say I want to start trading with 0.1 every time I have the signal to open my trades. Actually, you can start with percent. This means that you will be opening a certain percentage from your account. And I know many people are looking for that, but with algorithmic trading, it's way better to go for a fixed lot, so it will be easier for you to track the performance of the EAs at the end of the day. So I will stick to 0.1 lot as an entry amount for a new position, and the maximum position amount will be 1 lot, which means that if I have my entry signal after my first position is opened, I can add to this position with another 0.1 lot. Okay, next same directional signal, or in other words, if we have the very same signal in the same direction, we can add to the position 0.1. If we have opposite signal, if we have bought and then the strategy shows that we have to sell, we can do a few things. Nothing, meaning that we will leave it the way it is. We can reduce, we can close the position, or we can reverse the position. So it depends on the strategy that you were using. But for my strategy that I automated, I am using reduce. So every time there is an opposite signal, I will reduce from the position with 0.1. But my position will never exceed 1 complete lot, because this is the maximum position amount that I have selected. Now, what is my opening condition? This will be a moving average. So whenever the price goes through the moving average, I will have the signal to enter, and I'm using exponential moving average with period 105 and shift 115. And that's not all. I'm adding a second logic condition. And you can see that until the moment, it is a very losing strategy. And that's great with FSB Pro, because every time we make a change with the strategy, you can see the equity. Is it improving or is it getting worse? And my second entry condition is another moving average. Here we go. And I will use period of 14 as it is by default. And I would like the moving average to be rising. In other words, it needs to confirm with the first logic. Okay, when the first event happens, the strategy will check, or the robot, the expert advisor, will check if the second entry condition is met. And it will check with a third logic condition, which is the percent change. Let me find it. Percent change. Here we go. Percent change. It will work as a base price on open, and the period will be 52. Here we go. But the condition is not percent change rises, but percent change changes its direction upward. As you can see that until the moment, the strategy is very losing because I didn't set the exit condition, and I will change the bar closing with pivot points. I'm not sure if you're familiar with all of these indicators. I will not go into details about the indicators right now. Just want to show you how I'm building the strategy. And you see that the moment I changed to pivot points, already this strategy is profitable. However, I will change a few more things to make it even better. Exit long at S2 or short at R2. I'll click on that and I will increase the vertical shift to 285. Okay, and I will click on OK. And I have one more thing to change here. The base price is not 1 day, but 1 bar. And you can see what a difference it makes. Obviously, it took me quite a long time to go through the different indicator parameters, to add and remove some parameters. And to be honest, this strategy, when I was trading it manually, it was quite different. For example, I wasn't using the shift, which turned out to be vital. You can see what is the difference if I keep shift 0. Okay, super huge difference. Actually, I see a margin call, which is the thing we want to avoid, of course. So let me bring it back to 115, and there it is. We have a stable balance line. And no matter what your strategy is, you can play a lot with the parameter indicators. For example, with the moving average, you can start increasing it, go to 15. See, it's getting a little bit worse at the end of the chart or the most recent time. And if I keep increasing, I will see, is that actually getting better? Oh, with 18, it shows much more stable equity line. And just at the end, we have that drawdown. However, I keep it at 14 until the moment. And this is the way you can see how to improve your strategy. And of course, in the next videos, I will give you more tips on how to analyze your strategy using the analytical tools such as the comparator, the multi-markets, the Monte Carlo, which are great to have before you start trading with your strategy, especially on a live account. Okay, thank you very much for watching. If you have a manual strategy, FSB Pro is a great tool to automate your strategy. It will just save you tons of time, because if you test one strategy that you know from somewhere on a demo account and you figure it out it's not really working, and then you say, okay, period 105 probably is not the best, I will go for 100, and you will spend a few more months to see that still this strategy is not what you want to see. And imagine how many combinations there are between the different indicator parameters, entry conditions, right? With all of the indicators, we have different conditions. So FSB Pro really saves time when it comes to building EAs. And of course, we don't need to pay to developers to do it, because we can do it ourselves. Thanks guys for watching. I will see you in the next video.